welcome back to Dilly's ADV. Today we are going to dig into the DR350S a little bit more and see if we can resolve removing the nut on the primary drive. And the saga continues as we attempt to replace the timing chain. After going back and looking online, it was said that you needed to use a penny as a way to jam the gears between the primary and the clutch gear. Well, that's not gonna work. This is not the thickest socket, but it's still not gonna get on the nut while the basket is in place. The only other gear available is the one on the oil pump, but I really just don't feel comfortable using that one because it's so small and I don't want to damage the oil pump. Nope, not gonna do it. Think. Really baffled. How do I get this nut off? Upon further inspection, I believe that this may be a reverse thread. It is a reverse thread. That could be a huge portion of the reason it will not come off. So on this, the nut needs to turn righty-loosey, not lefty-loosey. Note that I have the piston rod completely cushioned in rag so it does not hit anything or bounce around. And there it is. It sure helps when you turn it the right direction. Now we can slide the gear off. Watch for the washer and the key so they do not get lost. And then voila, the chain comes off. Really, the chain does not look that bad. May have to make something out of it since I don't dare reuse it. The chain gear appears to be indexed the same, but it does come off. Okay, I thought it was stuck, but the oil suction was just holding it on. So, we are as far in the bike as we are planning to go. The next step will be cleaning everything up, including this nasty oil out of the bottom. It's not too bad, but I want to be sure it's all cleaned up. And then I can start putting everything back together. All the moving parts and tight fits will get some assembly lube. I'll also need to get the torque spec so that I know it's going back together right. Before we get too far, I want to check the cam chain against the new one to see how much stretch there is. And it appears to look good. I really could have gotten away with reusing it, but like I said before, I just didn't trust it. The next step is to clean out the old oil, draining the remaining oil by removing the oil plug and then cleaning the areas that I can with a rag and brake cleaner. Once I was happy, I came back in with an air nozzle and made sure everything was dry and there was no more brake cleaner pooling anywhere. I guess I'll have to be happy with that. I got all I could see and reach cleaned out now so I can start putting things back together. Nope, gotta take this back off. All right, now for the brand new chain. Nope, gotta make sure it goes around the primary before sliding it up. My hands are a bit too oily. There we go. Lay it right over there and slide the primary back on. Then the nut, then the clutch basket. First I need to put some lube on there, then the bushing, lubed, then the basket. Gotta wiggle it to make sure it meshes with the gears and is in place properly. Tell me what you think about this. I didn't order a new keeper washer. I really should have, but since I didn't, I will try to use the sides that were not bent last time, this time, so that it's a fresh bend. Okay, that is as far as we can go for now. I need to go look up the torque specs for this as well as everything else so I can get it all back together. All right, I'm back with specs in hand. This socket will not fit with the clutch basket in place either, so I have to take the clutch basket back off. Should have thought about that, huh? Now, to hold the primary while I torque it, I don't want to do any damage, so I'm going to wrap a large screwdriver with a rag and put it through the rod, and then tighten the primary to spec. This seems way too tight. It says it is 60 to 80 newton meters. As you can tell, I'm starting to get a little nervous about how it feels. So I checked the lower torque. Then 50 newton meters. Then then 57.9. It's just not feeling right. And now it's getting looser. Not good. Time to go back. It's fighting the whole way off. This is not a good sign. Well, that's crappy. And now the nut's stuck in the socket to boot. Frustration sets in. Well, come take a look. Yep, I messed it up. My torque wrench apparently does not work on right-hand thread. How poopy is that? I over-torqued it and messed it up. Ugh. I hope that did not hurt the connecting rod as well. I'll have to check that later. I think I'm going to try and get it to go back on just to see if it's going to work or not. Nope, not feeling enough resistance. Ugh.
Well, what do you do, right? So as you can tell from the last couple clips, this got a little messed up, and this, the bolt that goes on it, got a little messed up. And of course, it is the one that is left-hand threaded, odd-sized. I did a little digging on looking at this and looking at that and looking online on Thumper Talk. And apparently they say this is harder still, so it should not be as gummed up as the bolt. And apparently this isn't all that uncommon. A few other people had had the same experience and had resolved it without having to split the case and replace the crankshaft. So that's what I'm going for right now. The goal is I've ordered a new nut from Suzuki. Ends up being like $13 shipped. It's, yeah, I'll post a link in the description to everything I've found on that. And then I ordered a die. It's the M18 by 1.5 left-handed die to clean the threads out, because I believe what it did is it pulled the teeth over just on the tip. And I used my micrometer to just double check, and that's, it does look like that's the case. So I'm gonna go ahead and chase the threads, get all the crap from this bolt out of it, and put a new bolt and do some Loctite, and that should hopefully solve the problem. Now, to prevent this problem in the future, what I've done is I went ahead and ordered a bar-style torque wrench, because those can go both ways and you know what it's doing. The one problem I had is in using these guys, they're awesome. I love these things, but apparently they don't work very accurately on left-hand thread. So that being said, I don't want to risk it again, because that's how I screwed this one up, is I was going for the click, never heard the click, wondering what's going on. And just kept putting more and more pressure on there until it gave. So I've ordered a bar style torque wrench, and as soon as everything comes in, we'll go ahead and jump back on this. So the next couple of videos may end up being some other stuff, some other projects, while I'm waiting for stuff to come in. Hopefully all of it will be in within the next few days, and we'll get back at it. I really, based on everything that's been going on the last couple of days, I really want to get this buttoned up. I don't like the idea that it's being left open. I know I'm having a little bit of a performance anxiety, so to speak, where I don't want to get it all together and then have a problem, because then I have to tear it all apart, and that my brain's telling me just not to put it together, and then you'll never know. But that's not going to help either. So we're going to go ahead, we're going to get it put together, we're going to get it running, it's going to work, and we're going to have a good time with it. Because that's just where we're at. We need to get it running. Once we get it running, like I said in other videos, we can do a whole bunch of other fun projects to this bike to really make it a fun bike. But we've got to get the motor working first. So anyway, stick around, see where we go from here, and until next time, we'll see you then.